you remember the neck, the chain is not fitting. If you remember the belly, belt is not fitting. If you remember the legs, shoe is not fitting. The key is, if you forget the legs means what? Already, shoe is fitting. Same way, if you forget the body, you can be clear or you can be sure, already your body is fitting. When the belly is not remembered, you can be sure belt is fitting. For example, if you continuously remember your knee means what? Knee is hurting. If it is not hurting, will you remember? No. If you forget your boundary, you are healthy. If you forget your boundaries, you are healthy. If you are flowing like a air, if you are flowing, if you are walking like a flower, then you can be sure you are healthy. In Zen they say, human being is the only animal who makes path on the grass. Human being is the only animal who makes path on the grass. If you don't make the path on the grass, you are healthy. Strange. I want to tell you a small incident which is really shocked me, not even surprised me, shocked me. I went to Mudumalai forests. It's one of the big forests in South India, where thousands of wild elephants live, not hundreds, thousands of Indian wild elephants. They live there. There's a elephant safari, a termed elephant and a elephant trainer. Both will walk and take you around. You can sit on the elephant and go around and come back. I was going in the elephant safari. Suddenly I had a doubt. We are going into such a dense forest. How to find out the way? How to come back? I asked the guide, how do you know the way? How to come back? You are taking insight. He said, no, no, Swamiji. Myself and elephant, both of us, we walk. And the way in which I walk, it becomes a path. So, we can come back tracing the path. Because the same route I walk, it became a path. I said, how is it? You are making path and elephant is not making path. He said, that we do not know, but elephant don't make path. Human beings, they make path. Human beings, if they walk, even grass dies. Even grass dies. We may give a reason. No, no, Swamiji. Elephant has got a big leg. So pressure is distributed. In four leg, we have only two small leg. Concentrated pressure. All these reasons you can give. Again, try to experiment, to calculate. What is the pressure? I saw, after the calculation, it comes four times more than human beings. Even if you see the space of the elephant leg, elephant's leg space and the weight. Four legs and the weight. If you calculate, the proportion comes to four times more than human being. It is not the pressure or the weight, something else is working. If it is just the pressure or the weight, elephant is not making the path. But human beings are making the path. Then I really understood why Zen Buddhists, the Zen people say, if you don't make the path on the grass, you are healthy. Actually, if you walk like a flower, if you don't have toxins and stress in your body, understand, stress only gets accumulated as toxins. Stress only gets accumulated as a toxins. More stress, more toxins. If you don't have stress means the energy clots throughout your body. If you don't have stress, you will walk like a flower on the earth. You will see the very grace which is expressing in your being will be totally different, and you will never make path on the grass. You will never make dead. You will never make the grass to die. Forgetting the body, forgetting the boundary, forgetting the feeling that you have boundary is the ultimate goal, to be in bliss, to be in easiness, to be in total health state. But you can see continuously you remember some part or the other of your body, either the abdomen area, this is the area naturally we continuously remember, because that is the area we are all caught. You feel either stressed or always holding tight. You never relax yourself in that region. You never relax yourself in that region. Some part of your body, you are continuously tensed. You are holding it. You don't let go. You are not relaxed. First thing you need to do is let go the body. Let go the body. Whenever you remember, whenever you find time, whether you are going in car, whether you are sitting and watching movie, whether you are sitting and reading, or you are taking classes, you are doing your work, whenever you remember, witness the body. Witnessing the body means, it is not to be done as a meditation. Don't do it as a meditation, then you will try to escape from it. Then you will avoid, you will postpone. Don't do it as a meditation. Do it as a play. When you make this as a meditation, you make it too serious. Anything serious, your mind never likes. Never do anything seriously. Do it sincerely. Sincerity is totally different from seriousness. Never do it as a meditation technique. I always tell people, never do any meditations. Make meditations as a play, game for you. As long as you think it's a meditation, you will always try to escape. The other day I was asking her, she was telling me about Kriya Yoga initiation, which they took and they are doing. I asked her, how many of you are continuously doing? She said, many people took Swamiji, only 10 people come. That's the usual thing with any technique, any master. With any master, usual thing. Why? The moment you make something as serious, you try to escape. You don't want to do that. So don't make this as a meditation technique. Do it in a very playful way, in a relaxed way. Whenever you are going for a drive, whenever you are driving, just feel in a relaxed way how your legs are touching the brake pedal, or how your legs are touching the clutch gear, and how your body is seated, how your body is there. The moment you become aware of your body, you will see immediately your body adjusts itself for a comfortable position. Usually, we never keep our body in a comfortable position. Usually, we never keep our body in a body's comfortable position. We always keep it in our comfortable position. But body has got its own comfortable position. Padachari says, Sukham Stiram Asanam means, which is comfortable to you is the position for your meditation. Padanjali says, the father of yoga, he says, comfortable pose for you is the pose for meditation. We people, especially in the West, this yoga has become a big madness. And continuously standing on the head and torturing, bending, these, that, all sorts of gymnastics they do. Padanjali finishes his one word. Idam sugam stiram asanam. In which position your body feels totally relaxed and comfortable is the position for your meditation. Even in the car, if you start witnessing your body, automatically you will adjust. Your body will adjust. continuously whenever you remember, feel your body totally. When you feel your body totally, you will forget the boundaries where you are locked, where you are getting blocked. Wherever you are getting blocked, you will forget. One more small tips, you can at least note down these tips. These tips you can note down. These all, you keep it as understanding. Small things. You will see automatically you follow. Never think they are meditation techniques. I never teach anything which makes people bored. Whenever you are bored, you can be sure you will never practice. So never make all these things as a big ritual. Never make all these things as a you need to spend separate time in separate place. The moment you start thinking about a place and time, you stop doing the techniques. I have always seen. So never search for separate place and separate time. Let the meditation become your quality, not a separate quantity to be added to your routine. It should become a quality to be added to your routine. These few tips will guide you. Of course, whenever you do this type of camps, then do the meditation techniques intensely. You are welcome, you are requested to do meditation techniques regularly in the house. But most of us, we don't do. Let us be honest and straight and frank. Let us be very clear. Other day, one guy came and told me, Swamiji, I read a book about the injuries of smoking. How much it is injurious to health and how much it disturbs our well-being and all those things. Then I dropped Swamiji. Yeah, so nice. You dropped smoking. He said, no, Swamiji. Dropped reading books like this. Because they create confusion in me. So, when I say people drop TV, they drop me actually, instead of dropping the TV. So most of the time when I say meditate, they never do. So I give this type of different tips through which the quality of meditation will start working in your life continuously. Whenever you drive, whenever you sit and read, when you take class, when you are chatting with people, when you are sitting in a sofa, just see. Just feel your body for a second, for a few minutes. Feel your body. What all the portions are touching your sofa. In what are the points you are relating with sofa? What are the points with which you are relating with the earth? Just if you become aware of those points, you will see body automatically comes to a position in which you don't have to hold the body. Continuously, when you hold the body, you create pain. Understand, please understand, too much possessing the body makes the body disease. We always think if we care for body too much, body will be healthy. But I tell you, it is the other way. When I say don't care, I don't say that don't take care of the body, not in that way. If you don't possess the body continuously, the more you possess the body, more you disturb its functions. Because body has got its own intelligence. The more you let the body relax and let go in its own way, you will see body will have its own intelligence. One more thing. Never exploit your body. Never exploit your body. First is always keep the body comfortable and never exploit the body. Exploiting the body, you need to understand. How many times when you eat the gongra chutney, just ice will be pouring. Your tongue will tell, no, enough, leave me. Your stomach will be burning. But you don't even pick in one finger. What do? Your eyes are pouring. Your tongue is begging. Your stomach is burning. But just because of taste, what do? And the very word has made many people to get saliva in their mouth. I can see. Gongra chutney, the very word is more than enough to make the people feel the saliva. Never torture your body for the sake of your comforts. We always put the blame on the body. We tell, no, no, because of the physical pleasures only I have been destroyed. I have lost all my spiritual growth. Never blame the body. Actually, body is not exploiting you. You are exploiting the body. For your own taste, even when the body says, I am burning, I am not able to, what do? You force the body to eat. And till midnight, 2 o'clock, sitting and watching the cricket. Your eyes are begging to give you little rest. It is automatically closing. It is burning. But what do? You force yourself to sit and watch the cricket. For the sake of your comforts, you exploit the body. Never exploit the body for the sake of your comforts.